Hi, year ones. I'm Claire. Welcome to lesson 6. And today I'm going to talk some more about counting and numbers. In lessons 1 to 5, we learned lots of things. We learned how to count in ones. We learned the number names 1 to 100. We learned those counting principles that are really important when you're counting. And we learned about subitizing, counting in twos and counting in tens. Today we're going to build on what we know. And you may have done lots of learning over the last few days, and so you'll know how to help me more this time. Our learning intention today is counting collections in twos and tens, and estimating, counting, and checking. Since the last time, I made myself a book. You may have done the same. And in my book, I have put all the things that we learned so far. I put in the cards that we made with numbers, and I made myself a number chart. You may have done these things too. You may have been doing a lot of counting. Did you count how many times you bounced the ball? Remember last week I was bouncing my ball like, whoop, this. I wonder how many times you could bounce a ball. Maybe you counted collections of shells or beads or stones. Ella told me that she actually counted all the hot chips that she ate one night. Imagine, how many hot chips do you think she could have eaten? She told me. It was 32. Imagine, she ate 32 hot chips. And Sam told me that he had so many textures in his pencil case, he decided to count them too. Sam said he had 87 textures. That's a lot. Do you have that many? So what did you practice since the last lesson? Did you make a number chart? Here's mine. I even colored in some of the number patterns we talked about last week. Did you practice saying your numbers clearly? Did you remember about those teen numbers and those T numbers that we often confuse, like 30 and 13 and 50 and 15? Did you say them really clearly when you were counting out loud? Did you practice counting backwards and forwards from the numbers chart? Did you take a guess number in the middle and count backwards from any number? Wow, you have been learning a lot. So today, let's practice what we learned. So I want you to take your sticky notes or your scrapbook, whatever you've got, and I'd like you to write the number that is 1 more than 7. And while you're doing it, I'm going to do it too. So the number that is 1 more than 7. Excellent. Now, can you write the number that is 1 less than 3? I'm writing mine and you're writing yours. How about this tricky one? Can you say 3 less than 21? Can you write that now? I'm writing it too. All right, let's see if your answers are the same as mine. Did you have the number that was 1 more than 7? Look at me, I wrote 7. 1 more than 7. What is the number 1 more than 7? Of course, it's number 8. Did you write 8? What about the number that is 1 less than 3? Did you write 2? Excellent. Now, here was the tricky one. What did you do to figure out what was 3 less than 21? Did you think 21... 20, 19, 18. 3 less than 21 is 18. Do you have 18 written down on your piece of paper? Very good. Let's do some more practicing. So this time I'm going to hold up some numbers from my number pack. I've found this wonderful number pack. I'm going to hold up these numbers and you're going to tell me what they are. I'm not going to say anything. You're going to say them, okay? So look at the number and say it. You ready? And now. And this one. And this one. And this one. And finally, this one. Excellent. Did you get them all right, do you think? Shall we try them together? So, this was the number 3. And this was the number 15. Did we say that nice and clearly? Well done. And this is the number 18. 18. And this is the number 16. 16. And this one is number 6. And the last one we did was number 5. Were you really good at reading those numbers? Well done. That's super. Remember that number chart we did last week? We talked lots about our 100 chart, and it's really useful for knowing the numbers in sequence. So we're going to practice a little bit about those numbers in sequence. And we're going to see if we can count forwards from 71. So we're going to, first of all, find 71. How will I know where to find 71? Oh, you remember the pattern. Well done. So remember, it goes ones, then we've got those funny teens numbers, then the 20s numbers, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, and here is 71. So now that we've found 71, we can count onward. 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80. What comes after 80? I have to go all the way to the beginning of the side. 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90. Oh, have to go over this side again. 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100. Well done. We counted from 71 to 100. That's very good. This time we're going to do something very tricky. We're going to count backwards from 34. Let's see, can you find 34? It's not in the ones or the teens or the 20s. Oh, but it is in the 30s. Let's go to 34. Now remember, we're counting backwards from 34. So let's try that. 34, 33, 32, 31, 30. 29. Well done. Did you get 29? 5 less than 34 is 29. Okay, now I've got a number in my head and I'm going to see, do you know that number? So you can call it out when you know it, or you can write it down. Actually, that's even better. Write it down if you've got some paper with you. Okay, what number comes before 2? Have you written it down? Excellent. Now, I know that most of you probably put 1. Some of you may have put 0, because both those numbers come before 2. Well done, that's really good, isn't it? So before 2, we've got 1 and 0. And I haven't put 0 on my 100 chart, but I will soon. Now, I'm thinking of a number that comes between 93 and 95. So it's after 93. And before 95. What number could I be thinking of? Let's have a look at our 100 chart. So where am I going to look? I'm going to look in the 90s row, and I'm looking for a number that comes after 93 and before 95. What number could it be? Did you say 94? Well done, that's exactly right. All right, let's think of a number that is now 5 less than 50. Can you find the number on the number chart that is 5 less than 50? All right, let's go to our number chart. All our T numbers, remember the T, Y, T, it was over here. And 50 is right there. And now we want to go 5 less. So watch how I do it. 5 less. 50, 49, 48, 47, 46. 45. Did you get 45 was 5 less than 50? Counting backwards can be a bit tricky, can't it? Very good. All right, let's think of one more. I'm thinking of a number that is 4 more than 79. 4 more than 79. I'm going to give you a little time to do that one because that's a bit tricky. 4 more than 79. All right, let's have a look. Can we find 79 quickly? We remember where the 70s are. 79 is almost the last one, isn't it? And we want to go 4 more. So we're starting here and we go 4 more. Are you ready? 80, 81, 82, 83. Did you get 83? 83 is 4 more than 79. Well done. All right, let me see. I'm going to do something tricky now. I'm going to shuffle my cards and we're going to just count on 5 numbers from whatever card I say, all right? So whatever card I pull out, you're going to count 5 more than it, okay? Are you ready? Let's see, what's that one? 68. This time we're not using our numbers chart, we're using our heads, okay? So 68, how do I count out 5 more? 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73. Did you get 73 as your answer? 73 is 5 more than 68. Well done. Let's try another one. Oh, here's an easy one. 10. Remember I told you 10 is the mathematician's favorite number. So let's see. 10, 5 more, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And that's another one of our favorite numbers, isn't it? Any 5 number is a very favorite number. So 15 is 5 more than 10. I'm going to now do something tricky. I'm going to go counting backwards. So I'm going to count backwards from the next number that I show you. Now remember how to count backwards. It's quite tricky. You ready? 63, 62, 61, 60. What's before 60? Yes, 59, 58. Did you get 58 for 5 less than 63? Super. All right, one last one. Are you ready? This time we're going to count backwards from 62. 62. And how many are we counting backwards? We're counting backwards 5. So here we go. 62, 61, 60. Oh, there's the tricky bit, isn't it? What comes before 60? 59. Well done, you got that. 58, 57. Very good. Counting backwards and forwards by 5. You've done a very good job. You can do this at home with any pack of cards or any numbers, and you can practice counting backwards and forwards in 5s. Well done. When mathematicians have to count, they always estimate first. I think we did a bit of that last week, but we're going to do a lot more of that today. So estimating means that you're going to have a kind of a guess. But it's better than a guess because you're getting closer to what might be the right number of things there. So I'm going to estimate a few things today and then we're going to check by counting. All right, let's estimate how many Lego blocks I have here. I have quite a few, as you can see, and they're all different colors and shapes and sizes. And let's estimate how many I've got. Are you looking at all my Lego blocks? Yes, I've got a lot, haven't I? And some of them are stuck together. So I'm going to estimate first how many I've got, and then I'm going to count them. All right, so I'm looking at them now, and I estimate there's 500. What? Too high, you say? Oh, okay. It's not so good to have such a high estimate, is it? It's not a very clever guess, is it? Let me try another one. I estimate there's 4. What? Too low, you say? Okay, so 500 was way too high and 4 was way too low. They weren't proper estimates, were they? Okay, so let me look at them again and make a better estimate. So now I think I've got 41. 41. Okay, so I'm going to count them. You ready? So here I go. I have to take them apart because I'm counting in ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. Do you think it's getting close to my estimate? 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, what's next? 35, 36, 37, 38, 39. Was I close to my estimate? Who remembers what my estimate was? I was so close, wasn't I? Let's have a look at what my estimate was. So my estimate was 41. And how many did I actually have? I had 39. What's the difference between 41 and 39? Let's have a look. If I go from 39, one more makes 40, and one more again makes 41. I was only 2 out in my estimate. So estimating first is very useful. And mathematicians do it all the time. Okay, you might want to estimate some other things that you've got around your house. You might do your collection of shells. Remember when we did our shells the other day? Or you might have a collection of cars. Would you like to help me estimate all my cars and trucks? How many do you think there are in cars and trucks? Let's put them out here and see. Do you remember when we were counting them the last time? They started rolling away on us. But I've learned I can put them upside down. Then they can't roll away, can they? Let's see how many. Now, what's your estimate? I would like you to write it down. Write down your estimate of how many I've got there. And I'm going to write down my estimate. I was close the last time. Do you think I can get close this time? Mathematicians like to get quite close because it means that their maths was pretty good. So let's have a go at estimating how many I've got. It's a tricky one, isn't it? So some of them are bigger and some of them are smaller. I think, I'm going to write my estimate down. You write yours down. I won't tell you how many I've got, okay? Okay. My estimate, have you written yours? Yeah. My estimate is 15. All right. Is that close to your estimate? Will we be close to how many cars and trucks there are? Let's have a look. Let's have a look. Yes. All right. Let's try the cars again. I've turned them upside down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Wow, we were close, weren't we? We said 15. Where's 15 on our number chart? Here it is. And the actual number was 13. And the difference again, weren't we lucky? The difference again was 2, which was quite good, wasn't it? So 13, one more makes 14, and another one makes 15. So the difference was 2. We've done very well. Estimating is very useful when you're doing your mathematics. And mathematicians do it all the time. So the more you practice, the better you get at it. But remember, when you're doing it with somebody else, see, do they go too high or too low? And try and get them to have a better guesstimate so that they're closer to how many there actually are. After this lesson, you may want to do some more of your own mathematics, and you might, like me, put everything you've learned into a scrapbook. As you can see, I've put all the things that we've learned over the last few days into my scrapbook. And if you practice estimating, you can write your estimate into your book, and then you can count to check, and you can see the difference. Why don't you go and count some toys or spoons or stones and record your estimate and then the total? I'll see you next time.